And gave me valuable input. We were asked to present Annamachari Kirtanas for a program one evening. She said that she would do Palupu Thenilathali, the obvious choice. I looked at her. She understood the expression in my eyes and said, "Deepika, would you like to do this?" I said, "Akka, I've been so inspired watching you to Palupu Thenilathali for the last 4 decades. She said, "Go ahead and do it. I will do Okapari Kokupari." This speaks volumes of her large heartedness. She sent beautiful messages to me very recently when she watched the video I had done with my daughter as a tribute to healthcare workers fighting against COVID-19. She also called and told me that her daughter Anju really liked the tribute that we had done. I am truly beholden and thankful to all the renowned gurus and eminent personalities who have spontaneously poured in their touching tributes. Shobha Naidu Garu, you
will always be with us. Om Shanti.
Namaskar. I remember 1968. When Guru Vempati Chinnasathyam was coming into limelight and his ace student, Shishya, Shobha Naidu, was showing off the technique and the mastery of master. That Shobha Naidu went on to get huge recognition, not only as the beautiful Kuchipudi dancer, but also as one of the, I would say, pioneering dancers who took Kuchipudi far and wide. She was tall and lithe and with beautiful large eyes. I mean, everything that an ideal classical dancer in India is supposed to have. And Shobha had it all. Her Kuchipudi was flawless, beautiful, and elegant. Well, she has left us. We all have to leave one day, but then it pinches when a great dancer goes away. I pray for her soul to have peace, and I hope and trust that all dancers, regardless of Kuchipudi, Bharatanatyam, Odissi, whatever, will remember her with great affection and awe.
Namaskaram. We Raja, Radha, Kaushalya Reddy, and our two daughters, Yamini and Bhavana Reddy, are feeling so sad to miss Shobha Naidu, the great Kuchipudi dancer. We were shocked to know the sudden death of Shobha Naidu. She was a great, great dancer of Kuchipudi style, particularly in the role of Satyabhama. Bhama Kalapam, the creation of Siddhendra Yogi, is a unique combination. It's a combination of theater and temple dance. It's a combination of Natya Dharmi and Loka Dharmi, and combination of Angikam, Vachikam, Aharyam, and Satvikam, four kinds of Abhinayas. And when Shobha Naidu used to come as Satyabhama, she used to perform all these combinations. But when the Vachikam and her Natya Dharmi and Loka Dharmi, the conventional movements, expressions, and realistic movements, the expressions were unique. She used to do Bhama Kalapam so beautifully. That's why I used to call her always the Kali Yuga Satya Bhama. And other items also, like in Krishna Chabdam, when she was doing strati on the floor, sitting on the floor, when she was doing the expressions with her expressive eyes and hand gestures were unique to evoke rasa in the audience. So many people say she is so beautiful dancer, Kuchipudi dancer. Whole Kuchipudi community is going to miss Shobha Naidu. We all pray to Lord Venkateshwara to give peace to her soul.
Very great loss. Kuchipudi field has lost one of the greatest exponents, and I have lost a good friend, Shobha Naidu. She had been in Chennai for a long time, and I would never miss her program. And I still remember her as Padmavati in Srimasa Kalyanam or Satyabhama. Who can forget those beautiful eyes, her abhinaya, unparalleled footwork, and the grace with which she executed the entire choreography of her guru, Vempati Garu, is all something which made history. She'll ever be remembered for all those wonderful moments she gave to Rasikas. It was not an age to die. My heartfelt condolence to Shobhaji's family, her students, and all her admirers.
When I heard of the passing away of Shobha Naidu Garu, I was not shocked, I was stunned. I have always imagined Shobha Garu bedecked beautifully, ready to step onto the stage and start dazzling audiences with her dance. My association with Shobha Garu goes back a long way. In the initial stages of my development as a Kuchipudi dancer, it was Shobha Garu who was a very defining figure. When I joined Master Garu's academy, or I was trying to join, Master Garu told me, to watch his star disciple to get an understanding of what he was doing with Kuchipudi. I had gone with another background of Kuchipudi. So I watched her dance, and by coincidence I'm wearing this color. She was wearing a Kanchivaram Pattu sari costume of this color that day, I still remember. And what I saw was obviously very impressive. And that's what inspired me to join Master Garu's Academy. And as his senior most disciple at that time, and of course much later too, Shobha Garu was asked to complete my Kulvaithi Varanga Shai, my Bhama Kalapam, and also my Nilaminga Sharira Tarangam, which she did on Master Garu's instructions. I got to know her also as an aspiring dancer. She was already making a name and she was being featured in various interviews and so on. So she was getting photographed and videographed and filmed and going from to various cities, Bombay, Delhi, Kolkata, performing. And I was watching with admiration and imagining that I would do that too. Well, what followed, everybody knows. We have both been pursuing our careers as solo Kuchipudi dancers. And no two dancers could be as different as Shobha Garu and I. They're as different as chalk and cheese. Whether it is in terms of temperament, whether it's in terms of the way we approach our art, whether it is in terms of the way we dance Kuchipudi, everything about us is so totally different. And yet, whenever we've met very cordially. I hope, Shobha Garu, you will continue to dance. And you have indeed now joined the galaxy in heaven too, as you had occupied the space of the Kuchipudi dance galaxy on earth.
Namaskaram. It was a very sad day for the entire dance community when we lost Shobha Naidu Garu. I have an indelible memory in my mind of the very first time my mother and I saw her dancing. I think it was at Bharat Kalachar in Chennai. She appeared on stage and it was as though an apsaras was dancing before our eyes. I still remember vividly the extraordinary beauty of her eyes, large, lustrous, so very expressive, and her unique grace of style. Her vivacity, her smile which lit up not just her face but the entire stage. These days there is a lot of stress on technique, physicality, on sensationalism and seeking to impress the audience. But in Shobha Naidu Garu's dance, it was a perfect example of mastery that concealed mastery, because she rose above technique. She had all the brilliance and technical prowess, but she made you forget it. She made you forget yourself and lose yourself in her dance, so that the entire audience was enveloped in the warmth, in that special magic that she was able to create for the audience. I feel very sad that we have lost her so early. But she will live on always in the minds of all those who saw her dancing and in the hearts of her students. And I will remember her as my mother described her, as an enchanting dancing gazelle.
It is very much saddening to note that we have lost Srimati Shobha Naidu at the age of 65. She has been performing even at the age of 65, and she has been a dancer with the young artists. She has been a dancer with the old artists. Without any difference between the young and old, she has been mingling with everybody, every artist, and she has been encouraging the younger generation to such an extent that she has become Padma Sri Shobha Naidu, Dr. Shobha Naidu, Sanginatak Academy Awardee Shobha Naidu. And after having got trained by Dr. Vempati Chinna Satyam, she has shifted herself to Hyderabad and established Srinivasa Kuchipudi Art Academy. And she has taught about thousands of girls Kuchipudi dance. And her disciples are not only available in India, her disciples are available in foreign countries also. Shobha Naidu has been very much famous for performing the portrait of Satyabhama role in Sri Krishna Parijatam and Bhama Kalapa. Chandalika, Vipranarayana and Srinivasa Kalyanam also she has performed very well. I still remember she has been championing the cause of the women freedom, women movement, women's emancipation from slavery type of thing, and she was all set for the progress and prosperity of women folk on the face of the earth. Vijayostuti Nari, like ballet also she has performed in a very effective way. I know her for the last more than 40 years, but today we don't have Shobhanaidu amongst us. Now the youngsters and her disciples are to certainly continue the legacy of Dr. Shobhanaidu, and I pray God that the glory of Dr. Shobhanaidu becomes much more in the years to come.
Shobha and I were actually colleagues. We both got the National Scholarship for Advanced Study in Classical Indian Dance from the Ministry of Culture in the same year. It was 1970. I can never forget our final interview. It was in Sangeet Natak Academy, New Delhi. Shobha had also come. And what stalwarts were examining us, Professor Sambhamurthy, Dr. Narayana Menon, and the doyen, Varur Sri B. Ramya Pillai. Varura refused to mark me because I had opted to study under him in the event of my getting the scholarship. Both Shobha and I did get the scholarship, and she went on to study Kuchipudi under the visionary Vempati Chinnasathyam Garu, and I went on to study Bharatanatyam under the creative visionary Varur Sri B. Ramya Pillai. We used to meet often after that because we used to have examinations every year, and for our extension too. And once we both finished our scholarship period, we continued to meet during our travels in India and in other parts of the world, for very often we were performing in the same festivals. If Venpati Garu was Pygmalion, Shobha was his Galatea, for he sculpted the whole style on her. What a beautiful dancer. I remember how the judges used to be mesmerized by her dance, even as I was. She has left us too soon, but her dance is unequaled in lyricism. What a lyrical dancer. And that is how she will live on in our hearts. May Shobha's soul rest in peace.
First time when I saw her in Kuchipudi Arts Academy, it was 1971. She was practicing in Master Dr. Vempati Chinnasathyam's school. After that, I saw her ballet Sri Krishna Parijatam as a Satyabhama. Then I saw her dance recital in New Delhi when she came to New Delhi to participate Sangeet Natak Academy's Young Dancers Festival. She performed that her solo recital beautifully, and in those days all newspapers, like including Subudu Mama, praised her dance recital. After that, whenever she is on stage, completely she be involved in that character. She didn't think she's a Shobhanaidu. That is her speciality. So after that, I used to talk with her, and whatever small help she used to ask me from Delhi, I used to do for her. Then after some years, she shifted to Hyderabad. She established her academy and she produced her own productions. Like, I observed her lecture demonstration whenever she used to give lecture about Satyabhama, especially beautifully she used to explain, and sweet language of Telugu. Today, great artist, he is not in this world. Myself and Vanashree, our condolence to her death.
Today is indeed a very sad day. The world has lost one of her finest artists. We have lost Dr. Shobha Naidu, doyen performer of Kuchipudi, teacher, guru, choreographer, someone who straddled the world of Kuchipudi for almost four decades as its quintessential Satyabhama. Today we pray that she reaches the feet of her beloved Sri Krishna and pray for her Atma Shanti. We all really miss her, Shobha Naidu. We miss you, an extraordinary artist, a warm and dear friend. Atma Shanti.
It was in 1970, 71, we were organizing in Bombay under the Haridas Sammelan of Sur Singar Sansad, the festival called Kalke Kalakar. So in 1970 or 71, we had invited Shobha Naidu and Guru Vempat Chinnasatyam for a series of lecture demonstrations, because we are presenting gurus and also his star pupils in a dance demonstration and then followed by a performance. So we presented her and she impressed everybody. When I asked Guruji, Guruji had told me her name was K. Shubha, but K. Shubha did not appeal to me. Guruji said she belongs to Naidu community. So I said, oh, I know Sarojini Naidu. So I said it's better to call her Shobha Naidu. So in the press, we wrote next day about her name as Shobha Naidu. And then she became very popular with that name. Shobha Naidu and Kuchipudi then became synonymous. And then the rest is history. In all the principal dance dramas of Guruji, Shobha played important role. Parijat Pranam, Krishna Shabdam, or Krishna Parijat. So many dance dramas, Chandalika, I remember her acting. She would imbibe like plotting paper the way Guruji will teach her, and her face will become the playground of various emotions. All the Navarasas are at beck and call, and though she off the stage looked very simple, when she came, she almost transformed into one of those Apsaras in the court of Indra who descended upon heaven. She was out of jealousy. She never claimed to be a great performer. She was very, very humble to the point of self-effacing. And whenever I happened to go to Hyderabad, invariably I met her, and she was very happy to meet me and always remembered that I was one who gave her the name as Shobha Naidu. So even to the point that when there is any performance where I happen to be present in the audience, or I was in the chairperson of the festival, she would always remind the audience and tell audience that if her name is Shobha Naidu, the credit for that goes to Sunil Bhai, because he gave that name to her. That apart, she was very, very hospitable, very kind when we went for our book on Kuchipudi. Yes. And we have brought all those photographs in my beautiful book. Deepika Reddy, all other dancers who were a junior to her, even Anada Shankar Jayant, and many in Hyderabad.
Namaskar. It's with a very sad heart and a very wounded mind that I sit here today to pay my condolences to the legendary Kuchipudi dancer, Srimati Shobha Naidu. Her passing away was a moment of reckoning for me, because my whole passion and my journey with Kuchipudi dance began with Srimati Shobha Naidu. I watched her as a young girl performing the role of Satyabhama in Bangalore, in the famous dance ballet that Dr. Vempati Chinnasatyam, our guru, had choreographed, Sri Krishna Parijatam. And even till today, I can recall her wonderful exposition as Satyabhama. I hope she finds solace at the feet of Lord Krishna. Describing whom she danced for so many decades of her life. My heartfelt condolences to the family, and I'm one with the fraternity in expressing my deep anguish and sorrow at the passing away of the legendary dancer, Srimati Shobha Naidu.
Admirer of Shobha Naidu, Kuchipudi dancer. There are many times that I've met her. She's a versatile and excellent dancer, and I've always enjoyed photographing her because she puts everything into when she puts her costume on, and it works very well. I photographed her initially in Delhi whenever she performed, but then Sunil Kothari and I got involved in doing a Kuchipudi book, which took a long time, almost 10 years to bring it out finally. However, we went to cover at the Kuchipudi festival in Bombay in December 1993, and to get more and better pictures of the other Kuchipudi dancers in Hyderabad, we spent several days where Shobha Naidu was the best, and she was fully prepared to bring her costumes, her sets, and to do various items. And we enjoyed several of those photographs that have been used in Leela Venkatraman's book and in the Kuchipudi book that finally came out. And so we are going to miss her very much now. This is what's involved in the Kuchipudi book, was used by Sunil Kothari. And then one of the best pictures that has been used over and over again is in Leela Venkatraman's book on Indian classical dance. So we'll miss her. May she perform for the cause. All the best.
I was Master Garu's first Mohini in my Tata's, Devulapalli Krishnasri Garu's Kshirasagar Madanam. And I remember when my performances were taking up, my outside performances were, and solo ones were taking up time, and I could not travel with Master Garu, and Shobha took on the role of Mohini. Master Garu asked me, he said, Ratna Papa, can you please teach Shobha, the part, Mohini's part? And I remember teaching Shobha, and what fun we had when I taught her the part and she was learning it. And it was a bond. And we were friends while we were in the academy, and we kept up that that friendship. Something interesting that in 67, when Shobha arrived at the academy, she did join the Queen Mary's College. And surprisingly also, she became my student, because I was the English professor, and for all the undergraduate students came to me for English classes. And she never knew what to call me in class, because outside she was Shobha's Ratna Papa. And suddenly everyone else was addressing me as Madam, and she didn't know what to say. So she would say present and smile and keep quiet, and I would smile too, because our relationship was something else outside of the class. But then her dance took over, and she dropped out of college. And I don't blame her, because she was meant for dance. Long after I left to the United States in 1975, and then I kept returning every now and then for performances in India. When I went to Hyderabad, I would visit her. And she was the same. She was as friendly, as affectionate as always. And in fact, when Anju came into her life, her daughter, and I had visited when Anju was probably about 3 or 4 years old, she was so proud. She showed her off and she said, okay, this is your peddamma. Do namaskaram to her. And it was such a nice feeling to see Shobha, her life fulfilled with this beautiful little child, her daughter, to whom she could pass on her art. But I'm sure she's dancing for the gods. And I'm also sure Master Garu, who preceded her, must have welcomed her, saying, okay, Shobha, now I'm going to choreograph something special for you.
It is with a very heavy heart I'm speaking today. I never imagined that I have to pay a tribute like this to someone who is very, very close to me, whom I loved and admired. Shobha Naidu Garu has gone very, very early. I never imagined that she will go away like this, where we don't even have an opportunity to grieve. Our association goes back to almost four decades from the time I started learning dance. We shared many platforms, many occasions together. She was an elder sister whom I looked up to, and she gave me that affection of a younger sister. Her presence at many of my performances and her words of praise and appreciation meant a lot to me. I think she has touched many artists like this all over the world, and many must be mourning this loss. The most priceless gift she has given me is performing Sri Krishna Parijatam together. I played Rukmini and she played the ever beautiful Satyabhama. I can never forget that experience. She became a benchmark. She became an epitome of grace and beauty. She became synonymous with Kuchipudi. What tribute can we give her but rededicate ourselves to the cause of Kuchipudi, for the spread of Kuchipudi? Wherever you are, she has innumerable students all over the world, and I think we should keep her alive through our work, through our performances, and I'm sure she will find peace in her death.
When I came to know the sudden death of Srimati Shobha Naidu, I was in shock for some time. We lost a great Kuchipudi dancer, not only Kuchipudi dance form, in classical dance form of Indian classical history. She born for the sake of dance. We all know Natya Shastra is compiled by four Vedas. It is as a Panchama Veda. I think Lord Brahma created her for the sake of dance to present this Panchama Veda of Natya Shastra. In Natya Shastra, whatever mentioned for dancer's quality, Shobha Naidu is a very good example for that. We all know Rambha, Urvasi, Menaka, Tilottama, who were dancers at Indra Sabha. Now Shobha left us to dance at Indra Sabha, to predominate all those four dancers and to get appreciation from Indra. She is not only the dancer, she is Natyarani, Natyashundari, Nartana Shobha for the art of Kuchipudi dance. Though she is not amongst us today, the people will remember in future also by listening, by watching her videos, documentaries, and reading history of Kuchipudi dance or Indian classical dance forms. Our nation lost a great personality. She is not only the common woman, she is the queen of dance world.
I have to share one moment of when Shobha Naidu just came onto my mind screen, and she seized my heart and intellect and everything. It was a performance at Sri Krishna Gana Sabha in Chennai. I don't know exactly when, I would say the 1970s. She came like a streak of lightning. Her presence, her walk, her gait. I think I fell in love with Kuchipudi only because of her. You know, because I had not grown up in my Bharatanatyam days knowing of many Kuchipudi performers who could capture the stage and She was just something remarkable. There was a fluidity in her movements that I had not seen in Bharatanatyam. There was a lachak, like a kind of a arrogant swagger that I think she inhabited that character. I never knew her off stage. I didn't know her as a simple, quiet, generous, loving woman. But on stage, she was magnetic, she was charismatic, and she became the characters. I remember a moment when she sat. She sat and she was actually mouthing the lyrics of what the musician was singing. And I had not seen dancers do that. I had seen a dancer sing along with the musician, but I had not seen a dancer perfectly mouth the lyrics with the perfect abhinaya. So I think she was too important for the world of Kuchipudi, so symbolic of the rise of Kuchipudi as a classical dance form of its own, and she was the perfect muse for Vempati sir. Her loss has been like a planet has shriveled, a planet has disappeared from our dance firmament. I haven't seen anybody in Kuchipudi that can seize my memory like Shobha Naidu did.
She came, she danced, and she conquered. This is what I would say about the dream girl of Kuchipudi, Shobha Naidu. I always believe a good artist never dies, because it's her work that live for centuries through students and shishyas. I believe that one can never choose to be a dancer. Rather, it is the dance that chooses the dancer. So did it happen with her. Her father didn't want her to dance. The guru whom she approached refused to teach her because he felt she was not fit for dance. But then destiny took her to one of the best gurus, Padma Bhushan Dr. Vempati Chinnasathyam, who sculpted her into the dancer that she was. Is it just dance that a guru looks for? No, it's far beyond. It is the antaprana. It is the passion that probably the guru sees, along with the talent, the willpower, the grit that the artist has. But I'm more happy that after her demise, there were messages which said, I promise you, teacher, I will try and keep up this dance till the last breath of my life, and I will try to dance like you. And when I read it, I felt she lives in many hearts. And she's had her impact even on me as a performer. Her last performance for our online international first ever Kuchipudi seminar was mind-blowing. She just was scintillating. And she remarked at the end of her performance, probably that was the last 1 hour life's performance of hers, where she said, I will never forget this day. And today I say, we, the viewers, we will never forget your performance.
Tanu anukunnade sadhinchadaniki chala kashtamai padi tanu anukunna sthananiki cherindi kani ma anyonyata eppudu idavaledu tana పారిజాతంలో మేమిద్దరం కలిసి చేయడం కానీ చండాలికలో తను చేసినంతకాలం చేసి తర్వాత ఆ చండాలిక పాత్ర నేను చేయడం కానీ ఎన్నో అనమాచార కీర్తనలు అటు చాలా తొలినాళ్లలోనే నేదనూరి గారు కంపోజ్ చేసి పంపించిన గురువుగారు కంపోజ్ చేస్తే ఒక కీర్తన శోభక్క చేస్తే ఒక కీర్తన నేను చేస్తే ఆ విధంగా ఎన్నో రకాలైనటువంటి మధుర సన్నివేశాలని పంచుకుని పెరిగాము తన ఔన్నత్యం ఎంతటిదంటే నేను ఇక్కడ ఆంధ్ర యూనివర్సిటీలో పనిచేస్తున్నప్పుడు ఇక్కడ సెమినార్ చేయడానికి ఒక పక్క మంజుని మంజు భార్గవిని ఇంకో పక్క శోభక్కని ఇద్దరిని ఆహ్వానించాను నా మాటను మన్నించి నా మాట మీద గౌరవించి ఇద్దరు కూడా వచ్చి ఆ సెమినార్ని ఎంతో దిగ్విజయం చేసి మాస్టర్ గారు కలలు కన్న ఆంధ్ర యూనివర్సిటీలో నేను డాన్స్ డిపార్ట్మెంట్ స్థాపించడానికి కారకురాలను అవడమే కాకుండా వారి శ్రీనివాస కళ్యాణంలో హీరో హీరోయిన్స్ అనేటువంటి మంజు భార్గవ్ని శోభక్కని మళ్ళీ ఆయన కళలకు అన్నటువంటి ఆంధ్ర యూనివర్సిటీలో వారిద్దరి చేత భామకృష్ణుడి చేయించి నా ఆత్మానందం పొందడానికి శోభక్కు చాలా దోహదం చేసింది. తన జీవితాన్ని యువతరమంతా ఆదర్శంగా తీసుకోవాలి. ఎందుకంటే తను ఏదైతే చేయాలనుకుందో ఆ స్థానం చేరడానికి శోభక్క తప్పనిసరిగా తన చివరి దశ వరకు కూడా, అంటే చివరి దశ అనేది తనకి చివరి దశ లేదు, తను చిరంజీవి. ఈ విధంగా కళాకారులు అందరి మనసుల్లోనూ సుస్థిరమైన స్థానాన్ని స్థాపించుకునే శోభక్క తన చివరి వరకు కూడా డాన్సాన్ని వదలకుండా తను చేస్తూనే ఉంది. ఆ మార్గాన్ని చిరంజీవులందరూ కూడా అవలంబించాలని కోరుకుంటూ ఆ దేవుని సన్నిధిలో ఉండాలని మనస్ఫూర్తిగా కోరుకుంటున్నాను.
This great artist, who is a wonderful performer, good choreographer, and a fantastic teacher that I knew, to best of my knowledge, I would like to highlight two very important things about the services she has rendered to this dance. Firstly, among the people who have contributed immensely towards promoting this dance form across the nation was Padma Sri Vedantam Satyanarayan Sharma, who is the disciple of Bharata Kala Prapurna Chinta Krishnamurthy Garu. Thereafter, the most prominent exponent of Kuchipudi dance was Padma Sri Shobha Naidu, who took this art form beyond the seven seas and kept this Kuchipudi flag flying nationally and internationally. If we were to compare the facial expressions of these two performers, they were similar in the sense of that both were doe-eyed. I had the fortune of knowing her during my early schooling at Kalakshetra in the late 60s, when she was under the tutelage of her guru, Vempati Master, and immensely she ported all the major roles in his dance ballets. Later she established her own dance academy in Hyderabad and trained many students, also choreographed many dance ballets. May her soul rest in peace at the feet of Lord of Dance.
You are amazed at the way she maintained to be on stage for over 5 decades. And her passion, and more than passion, it is a kind of a, it's like, you know, she was wanting to be on stage, be the best performer herself. She has done either male or the female characters with such an ease. And probably after Venkatramaya Garu, she was the one who got the most name for her portrayal of Satyabhama. When you look at her choreographies, that she has also done several dance dramas. That's where I suppose she has taken, or you know, caught the quintessential quality of Kuchipudi and done several dance dramas, right from Krishna Parjatam. Of course, some of them are the ones that she continued from her guru. But after that, when you see post 1988, she has done several original works of her own, which include Navarasanata Bhamini, and prior to that was Vijayostute Nari. And then among her several works, when you see her Sri Krishnam Saranam Mama is the one that I suppose has given a very huge break to her, the dance drama of hers, where she plays the role of Krishna. I suppose that is the one where she has broken away from the influences that she had from her guru, where Guru Vempati Garu was insisting upon having just a kind of a suggestion on stage, but she has brought in realism onto stage when you talk about the decor of it. And also the choreography has actually broken away, especially the Nritta part of it, the Abhinaya part of it has broken away, and that's where she heralded herself as the choreographer. And I being associated, I feel fortunate being associated with her from 1980 to almost 91 for 12 years as a student, and then also as a performer along with her. The kind of exposure that we got and the kind of, you know, role model that we have seen in her as an artist, one of the boons that we had, one of the fortunate things that we had in our life. We miss you, ma'am.
I'm sure no words and any amount of words can truly speak and describe the contribution of Padma Shri Shobha Naidu Garu. A dancer who started dancing for herself has become an illustration of all the great works of her legendary guru, Guru Vempatichinna Sathyam Garu, who took Kuchipudi to the global platform and who stood as the synonym to the dance form itself. It was generations of dancers who got motivated, inspired, and were drawn towards the art of Kuchipudi dance. Difficult to imagine the world of Kuchipudi without her. Shobha Naidu Garu, as a dancer, teacher, choreographer, and a human, she was the greatest of all humans. She was there to welcome everyone, irrespective of where do they come from, which school or which bani or which guru they come from. She was always there to welcome and bestow her blessings on dancers of generations and generations. The warmth that she spread through her smile, pleasing words and touch, I'm sure she'll be bestowing her blessings and blessing us all with the strength and spirit to live dance as she did.
I have no words to speak. I'm very much thankful because now she's not with us. She went to dream world. She's a dream girl and she's a Satyabhama, and no one can fill the place of Shobha. But she's Satyabhama on stage, but in real life she's like Rukmini Devi, very soft, humble, loving woman. And I don't know what to say more words about her. We started our friendship Kuchipudi Art Academy 1966, I believe. We started our dance life, friendship, everything. We have no jealousies, nothing was there, because she looks very beautiful. Master has taken her as a heroine in Kuchipudi Art Academy, in all the ballets. And I used to do the second portions, like some other proportions. That's not thing here. I'm very sorry to say, I can't speak. Sorry.
The dancing fraternity lost a jewel, Dr. Shobha Naidu, whom we fondly called her as Shobakka. We grew up watching her dance at Master Garu's Academy. From a young age, I always loved watching her expressions. She was a wonderful performer, very expressive, and her eyes could communicate to the audience. She was such a wonderful human being. With her name and fame and the glamour she maintained during that time, while we were all very young, there was not a single day that she showed her greatness or her beauty or whatever, and she never had any egoism. That is one of the best character for a dancer, and I think that was there very much in Shobakka. We all traveled a lot to many performances within India with Master Garu's beautiful dance dramas, and she always treated every one of them, whether they are seniors, whether they are juniors, whether they are sub-juniors, with the same affection. She was always by herself, never troubled anyone. She never abused anyone. It's very rare to find such people. I think on her daughter and give them enough strength and courage to face this situation. Once again, my heartfelt condolences to Shobhaka's family. Namaskaram.
Today we are very sad that we lost a great artist, a celebrity, an icon of Kuchipudi. When we were learning in late 70s and early 80s in Kuchipudi Art Academy, Chennai, Shobhaka was already a celebrity and well-known dancer in Kuchipudi. Even then, she used to be so friendly, so loving, very sweet with all of us. And we were so close to her, near and very dear Akka for all of us. Her Abhinaya was mesmerizing. I always used to go to dance class to watch her Abhinaya, to watch her Satyabhama, role of Satyabhama. She is Apara Satyabhama, Abhinaya Sundari. Master Gar always used to ask me, Ivala, Shobhaka Abhinayam Chusava. And we lost that Shobhaka, with whom we performed and learned so much from her. But we can still celebrate her beauty, her passion to the art, her love, her caring for everybody, and her works to Kuchipudi. Me, my students of Academy of Kuchipudi Dance in Atlanta, my family, we pray for her soul to rest in peace.
I started learning Kuchipudi because of the influence of Subha Naidu Garu on me. I watched Master Garu Srinivasa Kalyanam in 1980 with Subha Naidu and Manju Bhargavi as the iconic pair. And that program moved me so much that I enrolled in Kuchipudi Art Academy shortly after. I was one of the first batch students, and I'm very privileged to be the first student to do the Ranga Pravesam under her guidance in 1982 at Ravindra Bharati. During my training with Subha Naidu Garu, I would love watching her rehearse and perform and learned so much from her. She had this great gift of Abhinaya with which she would transport the viewer to her world, and just watching her, we learned so much. She also gave me the opportunity to perform the role of Chandalika even before my Ranga Pravesam. And my time with her was so precious. I'm ever grateful. My gratitude and reverence for her will never fade away.
Namaskar. As we all know, a couple of days back, Padma Shri Dr. Srimati Shobha Naidu Garu has passed away. She was the dream girl and the queen of the Kuchipudi style of dance. I grew up watching her dance performances since my childhood. I still remember her roles as Padmavati, as Lord Krishna, as Satyabhama, which was the name with which she got lots of name and fame, as Sai Baba, as Vivekananda, and many innumerable performances and roles she has done. Even her solo items have got a lot of impact on the audiences. I remember one of her items, Dannama Charikirtana, Pallukute Nilatalli Pavalinchanu, which created so much of impact on my mind that I thought I should take up dance as my career. I pray to God to give courage to all the family members and her students to bear this irreparable loss. I remember a couplet here in Hindi which denotes her contribution to dance, which says that Hayat leke chalo, कायनात लेके चलो, चलो तो सारे जमाने को साथ लेके चलो. शी वॉज वन आर्टिस्ट हु वॉज लव्ड बाय द होल वर्ल्ड, नॉट ओनली द कुचिपुड़ी डांस और द डांस फ्रेटर्निटी बट द होल वर्ल्ड एज सच. आई प्रे टू गॉड टू रेस्ट हर सोल इन पीस. ओम शांति.
I met Shobha when she joined Kuchipudi Art Academy in 1967, when my sister Ratna Papa and I were getting ready for our Rangapravesam. I remember her always for her very expressive face, which spoke volumes, her limpid eyes, and the way she would use her lips to communicate, you know, through dance, her eye, her facial expressions, and her body language. I thought she was a consummate dancer. I watched Master Garu hone her skills, and I've seen her grow in stature with each year. One of my favorite portrayals of hers is, of course, Chandalika, where she made us all cry with the empathize with the heroine's role, and I think there was so much of heartbreak in that portrayal. You know, you just, your heart just breaks when you watch her emote, become the character. But one of my favorite characters is the lesser known, you know, Rukmini. She has done almost all the roles in Parijatam. Definitely Krishna, Satyabhama and Rukmini I have seen her too. But my favorite is Rukmini, where she brought so much of the pathos of Rukmini's role, especially when she does Ghazalane, you know, the sorrow which she brings in that, it's I can never forget her eyes and the way she looks up. She's, it, you know, I cannot believe that she's not with us anymore. And I'm sure she's entertaining the gods, Master Garu, and she might be choreographing something new for the gods right now. May her soul rest in peace.
My association with her is for about 10 years in Hyderabad when I was a dance critic. And I would just like to say three things about her. One is her bonding with her disciples. She used to treat all her disciples same, whether they are from a rich family, whether they are from a poor family, whether they came in a car or they came in a cycle rickshaw, she used to treat them exactly the same way. She will insist on at least three rehearsals before they go on stage. That is point number one. And secondly, she never insisted that, you know, they should go for Rangapravesham immediately. She never was after, she was against having a Rangapravesham within two, three years. The third thing is, she was, as a dance critic, I have never seen her or heard her asking me to give a review or a favorable review of her program. She will invite me for all the programs. I go there, I write my review, she will take it. And even if I write a very critical review, she will welcome me with a smile. But then Shobha was such a gem of a person. She will always appreciate and she will try to explain why particular thing happened that particular day. So we continue to be very good friends. Kuchipudi Art Academy, started by her guru Vempati Chinnasekaram, she developed it into one of the great institutions. Till her death, or recently, she has given her whole life to that institution. So that is what I like about her, and I can't imagine Kuchipudi Art Academy without her. And even after I moved to Bangalore, I've been in touch with her, and she used to appreciate, and we used to exchange a lot of ideas, a lot of thoughts. But I'm simply lost for words now. I don't know what, I can't go to Hyderabad without thinking of her. Thank you. Thank you, Deepika, for this opportunity.
My association with her began when I was just 8 years old, and I used to live with Shobhakka in the same house for almost 2 years in Chennai, while I was learning Kuchipudi under Dr. Vempati Master Garu. And I was with her until I shifted to Kuchipudi Art Academy on Master Garu's insistence. She was a sister, friend and a guide to me. I consider myself blessed that I was in touch with her on a daily basis, and we used to meet frequently and share a lot of stories. And the entire day, she would be laughing with a very childlike innocence. I have been great admirer of her, and the awe feeling is immense. I truly appreciate her, and she was a true Abhinetri. She was the one and the only dancer who could mesmerize the audience with her portrayal of Navarasam in her Abhinaya. She was a versatile artist. She could depict Lakshmi and Padmavati with a lot of divinity and grace. At the same time, she could portray a poor, untouchable, innocent girl in the ballet Chandalika with the same ease. You could see the arrogance when she's depicted in Satyabhama. At the same time, you could see endless love and humility when she portrayed Rama. She was a perfect, there can never ever be another Shobha Naidu. Satgati Praptirastu.
Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.